once you read the script, you can see that a lot of what goes on in the film is very visual. So you kind of want to fit in, as well as make the costumes something of a story themselves. They really describe who the character is visually. With Kara's costume, I really had to start by talking to Neil and what he wanted. Together we came up with the idea of a sand-colored dress, since the Lightwater town is going to be very sandy. So she kind of fades away. She's not really that noticeable. But at the same time, Neil really would like Kara to be unique and different in some way. So how does one put those two things together? A lot of trial and error. We've done at least 5 or 6 different designs of Kara's dress.
So you remember all of what we were discussing?
Yeah.
Linen colored, some detailing near the neck, and from that gypsy drawing you liked this scarf thing tied around the waist. We talked about the ways to dress up the bottom of a skirt with, you know, ribbon, 2 lines of ribbon, or some pin tucks. We fold the fabric up.
We've talked about the sleeve, and do we want the Victorian puff sleeve? We thought that was a little excessive.
I like this neck design best. And the gypsy sleeves going at the bottom, straight at the top. And then pretty much everything else from this image.
We have since talked about patches and making it look dirty. Dress is falling apart a little bit. She drags a little bit, rips in the back. Just making it look worn, like she's used it a lot.
There's Kara in her plain dress. And a red sash, which ties the back. Then when she's on the ship, she gets a little cold and she finds a shawl to put on.
Neil and I are both happy with where the design rests at the moment, but now is the time where fabrics need to be picked, whether it's linen or cotton, and then there's different types and different weights of those fabrics, how they're going to lie, does it need to be lined, is it see-through, how is it going to come across on camera. Then a pattern can be made and it can go off to a dressmaker.